I want you to turn your Bible into Genesis chapter 35, and that's where we are this morning. Genesis 35, Genesis chapter 35, c'est là nous imaginons, verses 1 through 7. I want you to pick up your English Bibles, ladies and young men who are looking at me, and you're going to read it in English for me this morning. I'm not going to read the text again, because we've been reading it for the past, few of Sundays. So I'll allow you to go ahead and read it yourself. I will simply read the first verse in French as you continue to read it in English. Ma plus seulement premier verset là en français et reste là avec les amis nous pendant le même temps. Genesis 3. Again, my sermon will be primarily in English this morning because we want it that way on third Sundays. So faithful, nous pour nous suivre avec nous parce que chaque troisième dimanche et jusqu'à ce que nous soyons bilingues et c'est objectif là, service là particulièrement en anglais. So bear with us, okay? Because these kids, you're not Baptist traditionnel. Si moi qui suis dans le baptiste, moi-même avec adoration, ma pasteur Zachary, non, et bien nous pas jamais. C'est pour nous bailler espace pour les gens adorer, créer espace pour adorer, then pour nous partager la parole de Dieu avec. Nous pas d'accord avec? That's the way. We're gonna do it. So, mes frères, nous tous, nous d'accord avec. The title of our message this morning, once again, is Go to Bethel. Let's say it together. Mont Abikel. Genesis chapter 35, verse 1. Dieu dit à Jacob, lève-toi, Mont Abikel, et demeure-y. Demeure-y là. Tu laisseras un autel au Dieu qui t'a paru lorsque tu fuyais Esaü, ton frère. Lorsque tu fuyais Esaü, ton frère. Father, thank you for the privilege of opening your word once more. I pray that you'll give us a special alignment so that throughout this, Father, you will communicate a powerful message to your congregation, particularly to the youth and children who are in the audience. And I pray, Lord, that you use this canvas that was prepared, this outline that has been prepared. Use it, Father, in your own way to communicate your word to our hearts. We come to you in Jesus' name. Let me just do a quick review on what I said previously by way of introduction. I said that Bethel in Hebrew means the house of God. And Bethel as a place was a little town north of Jerusalem with a rich civil and religious history in the Old Testament times. The Canaanites called it Luz. But Jacob called it Bethel after receiving a special message from God in that place. Again, today our message will serve as an invitation to all of us who are, again, at the beginning of this new year, to reflect on our relationship with God. It is therefore an invitation to trust God, who by faith has already preceded us into this new year. And it is above all an invitation for consecration, for purification, for collective commitment, for its personal expression of gratitude, and of course, of obedience to God. And last week I looked at the significance of Bethel, the last 2 weeks, and I'm just going to review again. There are three things that we said about Bethel. It is a sacred place in Canaan where Abraham worshiped God. Secondly, it is a place that was defiled by King Jeroboam, by his idolatry. And also, it is a place that God destroyed because of Jeroboam's sin. So this morning, our focus is on the first part. As we look at what Abraham did at Bethel, and also what Jacob did at Bethel. Bethel a une signification toute particulière, je l'ai dit, c'est le lieu côté Abraham qui a adoré mon Dieu, c'est le lieu tout côté Jéroboam souillé à cause d'idolâtrie et son lieu tout que bon Dieu était détruit à cause de l'action du Jéroboam qui commet. Mais message nous particulièrement dans ces messages, il accède sous première partie sur lieu d'adoration ça. Côté que bon Dieu était rencontré avec Abraham et côté que était rencontré avec Jacob. By way of summary, last week we covered a few things. Pour qu'on résume, nous découvrons quelques points. I'd like to highlight them again. First, we said Bethel was an invitation for personal consecration. Do you agree with me? Say yes. And on dit amen si nous d'accord avec. And you're not going to fall asleep on me this one. Second, it's an invitation to obedience. We'll look at it in the second sermon that we preached on the third. And last week we'll look at it, we'll look at the invitation of commitment and sacrifice. C'est trois ça on est considéré déjà. C'est encore, on a dit la semaine dernière là, c'est ton appel à l'action. But today's message will focus on verse 2, which is an invitation for purification. Let's say that with me, an invitation for? I want to hear you. An invitation for? That is second là, deux là. The second row, I hear nothing. Kids, let's say, what is the what we're going to look at this morning? An invitation for? In this part, we will look at first of all God's invitation to Jacob. Jacob received an invitation from God. Go to Bethel and abide there. N'a pas des invitations que mon Dieu fait d'abord à Jacob. Il dit Jacob, monte à Bethel et demeure-y là. Pour moi-même, c'est une personal invitation personnelle à Jacob. It was a personal invitation to Jacob, as it is to you and to all of us this morning, who want to enter into a much deeper relationship with God. It is an invitation to you who are here this morning. It is not a casual rendezvous with God, but instead an encounter of eternal significance. C'est pas un petit rendez-vous qui est avec mon Dieu pour passer, pour s'assurer, mais c'est un rendez-vous qui gagne une portée éternelle. Abide there. Go to Bethel and stay there. It is only by abiding in the presence of God that we will know Him, that we will experience His power. C'est seulement le nous rester dans la présence de Dieu que nous avons fait l'expérience de sa puissance. That's why he told them, go to Bethel, but not only to go there, but also to do what? To stay there. And let me remind you this morning, as you sit here, kids and young adults and youth who are here, stay where the Lord has placed you in this church. Stop hopping from church to church. Some of you have been doing that for years. And it's not only you, but it's adult also. Not fait sans d'arrêter voyage d'église en église. We happen from church to church. And forgetting that in order to experience God, we need to stay in His presence. Every church where believers gather, God is present in their midst. And that's what Jesus said. You don't have to leave a church to experience God somewhere else. If you're not connected with God, wherever you go, you will never experience His presence. Quel que soit côté où aller, tout parfait, ou pas connecté avec mon Dieu, ou pas besoin d'expérience. It's not this church that is a problem. The problem is you and me. Because if we don't have God in us, wherever we are, it's going to be missing. Ou arriver dans notre église, ou arriver pour marcher. You're going to go to another church and you're not going to be satisfied because the problem needs to be fixed within yourself. So by abiding in God, by staying in constant contact with God, you will know that He can save. You will know that He can deliver. You will know that He can protect. You will know that He can transform, but only God can transform your life. Et leur rester dans la présence de Dieu, ou à découvrir des choses extraordinaires, ou à découvrir que c'est lui-même seul qui t'a sauvé, c'est lui-même seul qui a baillé la vie, c'est lui-même seul qui a délivré, c'est lui-même seul qui a protégé, et c'est lui-même seul qui a transformé. And He is the only one who's capable of doing that. That, like, by way of exercise, I'm going to ask you to do that. Tell the person next to you, stay where you are. Go ahead and do that. Be obedient. Just tell them, stay where you are. Dis-moi dans mon monde, arrêtez côté où il y a. Même dis ça, arrêtez côté où il y a. And I know, moun qui a réfléchi dans vie d'église, nous connaissons bon Dieu là parmi nous. Don't you know? We know that God is here. He's been here. We've made so many experiences with God. And we don't need somebody else to come from outside to tell us that God is here. We know He's here. So stay wherever you are. Do not let life circumstances, friends, church members, church leaders, personal preferences take you away from this place. Des gens qui disent l'église, ça va se faire, mais j'en adore. Ou à l'autre côté, ou après mes gens adorés, ou après mes gens prêchés. Because you're not going to like everything. If you don't like the way we worship, you live for another church. When you go there, you're going to like the worship, but you're not going to like the preaching. Because you will never be 100% satisfied. Stay wherever you are. C'est ça mon Dieu dit. Et Jacob, la tour, Jacob, go to Bethel that and stay. Demeure-y là. We are confident that God is about to do something big at the church. And He wants you to be part of it. Amen. Let me say that to you again. God is about to do something big at the church. And He wants you to be part of it. But in order for you to be part of it, you must be here. Let me say it again. In order for you to be part of it, to take part in what God is doing here, you need to be here. He's not going to pick you up from wherever you are, but if you're here, you will experience His power. Amen. You will experience His presence. You will experience the great things that He's about to do. Bon Dieu, gain bagay extraordinaire la fête dans l'église. Commencez déjà. Il va. Mais pour vous capable d'expérimenter ça avec mon Dieu, c'est là. You need to be here. So, c'était l'invitation à Jacob. That was Jacob's invitation. And that's your invitation. Go to the presence of God and stay there. The second invitation is also very important. We find it in the next verse. It is an invitation from Jacob's there to his household and to God's people, to the Israelites. Deuxième invitation, c'est l'invitation que mon Dieu Jacob lui-même lui prend fait à maison, la caille. Parents who are here, c'est la caille. Et ensuite, à l'autre monde qui a fait. What was the invitation? Jacob said to the people, take away the foreign gods that are in your midst. Purify yourself and change your garments. Jacob dit à sa maison et aux autres personnes, enlève les dieux étrangers qui sont au milieu de vous. Purifiez-vous et changez vos vêtements. Three things in this invitation. Jacob dit d'abord, 1. Retirez Dieu étranger. 2. Purifiez-nous. Et troisièmement, changez-vous. Tous les trois, ça sont extrêmement importants dans le contexte civil. All these three things are important in the context of this series. First, this is, to me, it's a revival invitation to the Israelites as we're getting ready to settle in the promised land. Songez mes peuples quand tu as parlé dans la terre promise. Bon Dieu déjà parole, mais des bagailles pour nous faire des things that they needed to do. And he's telling them, go ahead and purify yourself in order for you to experience God's presence and God's power. Donc si Echidici besoin faire l'expérience de la puissance de Dieu, nous besoin faire quoi? Purifier. Take away the foreign gods. To me, this is a revival message. And I believe that the revival started this morning. Avec deux chorales qui sont chantées la matin. Nous croyons que le réveil a commencé déjà dans l'église. It began with these two choirs who sang this morning. To me, it's not something that you're going to do one Sunday and then disappear. Go to Bethel and stay there. What you started in January will continue in February, in March, in April, and when we get here again in December, you will be singing here in this church. That's what it means. So this is a revival that the Lord is communicating to Jacob, and Jacob is communicating also to his people.
The reason why I said that is twofold.
One is because the revival is often ushered by a word from God, transmitted either directly by God himself or through the means of an intermediary. Qui sont réveillés, eh bien, ils ont réveillé, Seigneur, le bon Dieu. Ils ont commencé à partir d'une parole que bon Dieu lui-même lui proclamait avec leur bouche parlée. God says to Jacob, go to Bethlehem. Lui-même lui proclame. Mais maintenant, qu'on y a une deuxième dimension, c'est le transmettre d'un intermédiaire, ou l'autre intermédiaire, pour transmettre ça. He's going to use an intermediary to transmit this message. He's going to use the lips of Jacob to tell Israel what they need to do. Et qu'on s'abattient la servie avec lève moi pour vous qui sont besoin. He's going to use my lips this morning to tell you, kids, you, young adults and adults, what you need to do. Take away the foreign gods, purify yourselves, and change your garments. So this morning, here's what the Lord is telling us, and I want you to listen to me very quickly. And I know I'm told that kids and youth, they don't have long attention span. It's very short. And I'm going to use the time to the maximum. Four things that God is saying this morning. Quatre bagailles que Dieu a dit nous matin. First, God is telling you, change your ways. Let's say that together. Change. I want to hear it. Change. Say it louder. Change. So you need to be more obedient, more grateful, more sensitive to God's call. I'm not going to go through the text, but you're going to say that Jacob remembered that God was with him, so he needed to be grateful. Amen. Don't you have to be grateful, kids, you, adults, parents? Don't you have to be grateful to your parents? I've heard some comments, particularly during VBS, that sometimes you mad with your parents, those Haitian parents, they don't know what they're doing. Let me tell you, Haitians are the smartest people in the whole world. I say, c'est pas qui est intelligent, il est dans le monde. I'm telling you. Pas comme on dit qu'à Fidji, il y a pas qu'on est plus mauvais Haïtien. I'm telling you, this is true. This is true. Very smart. Be obedient to your parents. How many of you are rebelling against your parents sometimes? Because you think they don't know what they're doing. Because they don't speak English. They only speak broken English. So they don't know what they're doing. But let me tell you, regardless how they are your parents, and they're going to remain your parents for life. So you need to be obedient. Change your ways. If you are rebelling against authority, change your ways. If you are rebelling against your teachers, change your ways. If you are rebelling against the church leaders, let me tell you that this morning, change your ways. Because by doing so, that you will experience God's presence. See, l'autre bagaille ça, vous pouvez l'expérience de Dieu. But you cannot do that unless you abide in God's presence. So, pas quitter ses volontés, mon Dieu, qui a exercé dans la vie, eh bien, c'est vous pas besoin de cacher. Change. Peut-être Dieu aussi adore qu'il a oublié pas faire bagaille, il veut changer dans tout texte. Est-ce que nous ne pouvons pas nous comme parents, grand monde, il fait bagaille, il veut changer. Dans la rapport, on voit mieux de façon, il veut changer dans Dieu texte. J'en vous traite, on va faire, il veut changer. Moi, on aime se changer. Peut-être que vous ne pouvez pas connaître, mais there are ways. T'as vu du texte qui fait 100 ans, Timou n'a pas venu pour côté de nous. Il y a des fois l'église, c'est nous-mêmes, nous avons pété au dehors. Excusez-moi, nous ne pouvons pas faire ma vie, parce que pour Jean nous déclarons, nous besoin de parfait. Mais pas pour nous, mais nous ne pas faire, nous besoin de notre petit parfait. Je ne vais pas dire à mes jeunes, ma mère cherche à rien à ma vie faire, ma vie quand même, ma vie quand même. Parce que bien sûr, c'est nous-mêmes qui vivons de mieux dehors. It's us, it's somebody on the part. Change your ways. Deuxièmement, secondly, not only. They needed to change their ways, but they needed to change their attitude towards God. Les gens qui pensaient bon Dieu a servi son petit bon Dieu, ils peuvent servir un big God. So if we serve a big God, then if God is bigger than my problems, is bigger than my circumstances, if he is bigger than anything that I am facing. Kids, we need to change your. No, you have to leave I need your attention. You need to change what? Your. If you're on your phone, you're not watching, you're not following me. You need to change your attitude. Don't you have attitude?
Yes.
Some of you here this morning is an attitude adjustment. I believe somebody here needs an attitude adjustment. The way you respond to your parents when they talk to you, the way you roll your eyes when they talk to you, you know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about. You know exactly what I'm talking about, kids. The way you slam the door because you get upset over something that they tell you to do, you know what I'm talking about. Change your attitude, not only your ways, but also your attitude. There's a philosopher who said your attitude determines your altitude. The way you see things depends on how far you can go. The way you perceive life depends on how successful you can be. You can be successful in school if you think school is important. There are some kids who do not succeed in school because they don't think school is important. Because they realize that there's maybe two or three who never went to school and they're successful. That's maybe two or three out of millions. Change your attitude. Maybe towards one another. Ici, dans nous, comme grand monde, parfois nous devons changer l'attitude. Nous devons attitude, nous, Bible, ici, dans l'église, ça a démarré dans la famille déjà. Nous devons attitude. Nous n'avons pas besoin de dire amen, mais très bien pour nous. Mais peut-être quelque part, quelque chose, traiter le monde, c'est que c'est au dit, nous n'avons pas mettre ici dans le vent. Quelqu'un qui a attitude, peut-être pas moi, nous devons aller déjà. Ou bien quelqu'un qui a attitude, nous devons aller déjà. This morning, God is telling you what? Change your attitude. On nous change d'attitude envers nous l'autre. Parce que c'est frère, c'est soeur, nous, we are brothers and sisters, let's treat one another as brothers and sisters. I want your attention, kids, I want your attention. If you are talking to one another, you're not paying attention. I've almost done. Change your ways, change your attitude in order to go to better. Troisièmement, change companies. And take away the foreign gods. C'est pas ça que je dis. Il y a quelques gens qui ont fréquenté pour la vie de côté. There are some friends that you have, you need to let them go. I'm talking to you all. I'm talking to you. There are friends that you have in your life that you need to let go in order to experience God's presence. Particularly those who are exerting negative influence on you. There are some of them that are very influential. More influential in your life than your parents, than the church leaders. And you listen to them. You connected with them 24/7. You need to cut them loose somewhere. Yes. And I'm going to ask you to evaluate those that you need to cut loose. Il y a quelques monde qui nous la vie, qui disent ça à la parole des parents. Nous avons besoin de quitter les gens. C'est des gens qui sont négatifs. Mettez de côté. C'est des gens qui sont négatifs. Non, c'est un ami à la parole. Positif en s'en a dans la dos. La boue l'église presque plein à terre. Mais mon qui négatif, on a dit l'église presque vide, c'est pas ça? That's what it is. Restez bon côté mon qui positif. You need to break away from some friends. Mon prix, c'est l'expression anglais qui dit l'ex English expression, c'est birds of the same feathers, what do they do? I know you know it, they flock together. Let's say it again. Birds of the same, they flock together. What happened? Où Jean ou les oiseaux, petits oiseaux vont marcher avec Corden? No, they're not. They're not together. The little, the hummingbird doesn't go with the eagle. One will kill the other, and you know exactly who's going to get killed. Not the eagle. The hummingbird. So what does that mean? There are some people that you know you have in your life today that you need to get rid of. I may not know them. Your mom, your dad probably won't know them. Because when you connected at night in the internet with these individuals, you know exactly what's going on. How do I know? Maybe you're going to say I'm that under prophet. No, I'm not. Because I know. Well, the internet, anything is possible. Anything is possible. Let me tell you why you may need to disconnect with them and why you should make that decision this time. If you see that your friend is telling you school is not important, get rid of that person. Can I say that again? If they're telling you still school is not important, get rid of that friend, because that person is not your friend. If a person is telling you that purity is not important, in other words, sex before marriage is not important, get rid of that person. If that person is telling you that marriage is not important, get rid of that person. We hear that in society, don't we? If they're telling you church is not important, get rid of that person. Leave their company. This is simply a scheme from the enemy to destroy you and to destroy your dreams. En pilant nous notons Dieu, mais nous pas réaliser que c'est Satan qui a agi pour détruire. Left, God has big dreams for you. But don't listen to the friends who are leading you astray. Some of them are doing just that. Maybe some of you already paid the price for it. Zambi qui vous fait mettre des actions, des actions, do this action, just try this once. What, how many times did they say only once? And you fall in, and you fall for it. And you regret it for the rest of your life. This kind of friends, what do? You need to let them go. Cut them loose. Pas arrêté, attaché avec eux. Get rid of them. Qui l'a bagaille la petite encore? Change direction. There's a direction that you're taking in life, and when God's voice talks to you, you need to take heed to what God is telling you, and then change. And if you don't change direction, you're going to enter into collision with God. Qui t'aime tout ça, si vous pas changer direction parfois, vous allez entrer en collision avec ton Dieu. Vous ne pouvez pas faire quelqu'un nous penser nous plus smart que mon Dieu. Some of them must think that we're smarter than God, don't we, think so? 21st century, you are 21st century kid. You know a lot of things. Computer is yours. Look at this. This guy playing his with the telephone here. They're listening to my sermon, but they're playing with the telephone, sending messages, isn't it? Yes, that's smart. Isn't it? You're outsmarting the preacher. Isn't that correct? You think you're smarter than God. But if you don't do the right thing, you're going to enter into a collision with God. Please, as I continue to preach, put all the telephones away. Put them away, because you're not on call. If you were on call, you may show me your medical license. And I know you have patients that are dying, and you want to be rich. Please help me with that. When you come to church, put it away. You need to change direction. If you know what you're doing is not pleasing God, you need to do what? Change direction. Let me give you this illustration very briefly. This gentleman was working night shift in a lighthouse, and maybe about a mile in the sea, he noticed a light coming towards him. And he sent a signal and said, change 10 degrees north. It was another big boat that was traveling the high sea. And Admiral of that boat sent a message and said, you change direction 10 degrees north. The gentleman sent another signal. He said, I say change direction 10 degrees north. The other gentleman sent the other one sent a message and said, no, you change direction 10 degrees north. The gentleman sent another message. He said, I'm telling you, I'm warning you, you need to change direction 10 degrees north. And the captain of the boat sent a message and said, this is Admiral Alexander. And I said, you change direction 10 degrees north because I am the U.S. destroyer, and I will destroy you. And the other gentleman sent a message and said, yes, you are Admiral Alexander, but I'm telling you 10 degrees north because I'm a lighthouse. And if you don't change 10 degrees north, you know you're going to get crushed. I don't know if you get the message. The lighthouse, c'est un phare. Phare à déplacer quand il est dans la mer. Donc, Andy Van a envoyé des sacs, il a dit, monsieur, il faut changer, t'es une prison, mais c'est lui-même qui a besoin de changer de direction. Et finalement, he got the message that was very late. According to the story, he crashed anyway in the lighthouse. Get quelqu'un qui attend, c'est là nous faire collision avec Dieu. We're waiting until we collide with God to understand that we need to change what? Kids, I want you to say it for me. Young says, do I see him off from? Look, what's this guy's name? Say it for me. If you don't want to wait until you collide with God to change what? Direction. This is directional direction, but I prefer direction. Okay? You change direction when God says change direction. And you know what you're doing that's not pleasing God. And He's telling you this morning, as He said to Israel, change direction. Change your ways. Change your attitude. Change. I thought they were with me. And change your direction. And thirdly, the third point that we have in this text, in verse 7, is Jacob's priority. God's invitation, and Jacob's priority. Let's say it with me together. Say that. Jacob's priority. Say it again. Jacob's priority. Jacob. There he built an altar. He called this place El Bethel. That means the God of the house of God. Allez construire un hôtel et lui venez El Bethel. Nous ça veut dire le Dieu de la maison de Dieu. El Dieu, le Dieu de la maison de Dieu. Now what his priority? His priority was to please God and do what God commanded. What was his priority? To please God. What's your priority this morning? Are you here to please God?
Yes.
Or are you here so that you can have fun? Or meet with your friends? Je me dis que c'est ça, mais vous êtes taille, mon âme. Vous pouvez faire chef, même vous êtes chef. Mais l'homme d'une église, priorité, c'est qui ça, c'est vite fait, bon Dieu, les. Jacob's focus was not on the house of God, per se. C'est pas sur la maison de Dieu en particulier, mais c'est sur le Dieu de la maison de Dieu. Attends, do you get this? Focus, c'est sur le El Bethel, ça s'appelle révèle la maison de Dieu, mais c'est sur bon Dieu à consulter. Pas sur la maison, parce que maison ça caille, ça vaut de la valeur, la gloire va bien, pas au présent en rien, si bon Dieu va là-dedans. If God is not in here, they can have a dancing here. The house, the God of the house of God. If your focus is not on God, you are wasting your time. Des mondes qui passent tout le temps en vie ça, ils regrettent qu'ils n'ont pas été avec Dieu là. If God is not the focus of your life, you are wasting your life. Therefore, kids, your God will tell you, if serving God is not a top priority for you, you are wasting your time. And this morning I'm going to tell you one more thing. Change, I mean, get your priorities in order. Make the priority for you, Lord. What's your priority? Is serving God your priority? If it's not, maybe this morning. Set your priorities in order. Priority? If God is priority, that means the game that you spend most of your time playing at night needs to be put away. The Bible will be your best friend. How many of you can say that? Before you go to bed, you pick up your Bible and see exactly if there's a message that God wants to communicate to you. If you're not doing that, God is not priority in your life, has no priority in your life. Then you need to set your priorities in. Yeah, there's time to play, but there's also time to spend with God. Get l'heure pour jouer, mais get l'heure pour passer avec Dieu. And if God is not priority, it's not the priority in your life, why committing to God? And that's why we have so many youth, but sometimes adults in the churches, they're there, but no commitment whatsoever. My message to you this morning, God is telling you, set your priorities in order. Let's say it together.
Set your priorities in
order. Why is it important? It's because by making God my top priority, that I will experience His power. That I will experience His presence. C'est le faire bon Dieu, priorité numéro un dans la Bible, c'est le faire tout bon vrai. Nous avons expérience présence. I can come to church every Sunday, never experience God. Because God is not a priority in my life. Kids, let me ask you that question. How many of you would want to make God the top priority in your life? By a show of hands, let me see how many of you would like to do that. You in it also? Don't raise your hands and just please me. But do you really want to do that? And if this is the case, they're not going to force you to come to church. They're not going to force you to come to rehearsal. They're not going to force you to read your Bible because you know this is going to be important for your life. Nous avons souhaité que nous tous dans l'église en fait bon Dieu, par bon Dieu, priorité dans la vie. Et texte dit, selon Jacob fixe ses priorités parce qu'il réalisait, s'il n'a pas fait mon Dieu plaisir dans la ville, on n'y est pas marché. Et là, il dit, mon Dieu, priorité, mon Dieu dit, monte avec elle, demeure-y là, et puis fait exactement ça, mon Dieu dit. Hein? Et puis nous gardons un temps pour lire le texte. Il dit nous à la fin du texte que le peuple Israël arrive, mais fin, monter devant mon Dieu dans la purification. Il dit, mon pas jamais lui encore. I don't know if you ever took the time to read it. Il dit dans verset 5. Ensuite, ils partirent. La terreur de Dieu se répandit sur les villes qui les entouraient. Et l'on ne poursuivit point le fils de Jacob. Les bons dieux priorité dans la vie, mais mes ennemis ont couru. Et pas où ça couru pour les autres. Ni même ni couru pour vous, parce que le fond n'est pas seul ou accompagné de Dieu. The God of Jacob. Is going to be the God of HBC if we set our priorities in order. On nous fixe ses priorités. Now, to you all as adults who are here, et ça c'est important. Si bon Dieu priorité pour nous dans la vie, nous n'avons pas même besoin de nous venir dans la réunion prier ma disson. Nous n'avons pas besoin de dire amen tout ça, nous sommes dans la fiche. Ou à qu'on est ma disson, ou à pas arrêter la réunion prière, mais tu dis vite. Ou à qu'on ait activité régulière à l'église, ou pas karaté, parce que c'est une opportunité pour fortifier foi. It is an opportunity that you have to strengthen your faith. When the church comes together. Et si mon Dieu pas priorité, ou après que la parole. Let me allow me to share that. This little conversation I had with my son this morning. I said, when you don't go to church on Sundays, what do? He said, football. Isn't it? When you don't go to church, what do you do? Football. I call it Football Baptist Church. And isn't that correct? On pile pour nous réunir à Kailou, c'est pas un yé, je sais que vous avez fait nous, mais on était devant la télévision, pensant que vous avez fait nous, on est même. C'est tant que tu es devant la télévision, tellement de bagailles négatives là-dedans. Quoi, vous voulez 5 minutes dans la présence de Dieu vaut 1000 années ailleurs. C'est ça, Samy Sandil. Un instant dans la présence de Dieu vaut 1000 ailleurs. Come to the presence of God. When God is priority for your life, nous pas besoin de forcer pour servir mon Dieu. Nous pas besoin de forcer pour faire quoi que I promise that I was not going to be long this morning. But the songwriter of the 20th century, Thomas Obadiah Chisholm, captured this morning message in the verses of this song, which I will invite you to sing with me as a prayer. M'a invité nous pour ne l'aider sous pas qu'à chanter, nous va lire avec as a prayer. L'y traduit tout ça, la vie de Jacob, l'y écrit texte ça, in the 20th century, 1976. He wrote that song. Living for Jesus, a life that is true. Striving to please Him in all that I do. Yielding allegiance, glad hearted and free. This is the pathway of blessing for me. And he put that refrain in this manner. Oh Jesus, Lord and Savior, I give myself to you. For you in your atonement did give yourself for me. I own no other master My heart shall be your throne. My life I give henceforth to live for you alone.
Pour un exemple, nos chants de consécration qui est important que notre cadet. I would like for you to read this with me in English.
En tant qu'on prière, ma mère, as a prayer, let's read this.
Since God is summoning us to come to Bethel for purification, let's make that bold decision.
Let's read this as a prayer.
If you want to go back, we're going to read it together.
I know you can read it, and you can find it, you can see the
Let's do it.
Living.
Let's say it together.
Living.
Number one.
Living for Jesus. faire rester dans mon autre. Nous comptons sur vous pour faire chercher rester dans Dieu. Nous comptons sur vous pour faire chercher la sanctification. Nous comptons sur vous pour faire rester dans volonté.
I want to count on you
to keep my commitment.